Well, I won't back down, and I won't back down. Hey, I will stand my ground, and I won't back down. No, I won't back down.
Electric vehicles. Electric vehicles are the worst thing to happen to humanity. Let me explain. The raw materials required to produce EVs are becoming more scarce by the day, especially those required to make their massive battery packs, such as lithium, nickel, and palladium. Due to the costly and hazardous nature of mining lithium and nickel, it is expected there will be a shortage as soon as 2025.
Can I have the next slide, please?
Through confidential informants within ICBC, I have learned these battery packs are prematurely expiring after 1,000 to 40,000 kilometers. These battery packs are costly to replace. Depending on the brand of your vehicle, they can be anywhere from $5,000 to $20,000. And now something you've all been waiting for, and something I'm sort of known for, the anti-government rant. Some believe that the government doesn't even care about the environment. They just want to control you and your life more closely. Before anyone comes at me with, oh, the government wouldn't do that. Oh yes, they absolutely would.
Drop it.
Just recently, the government of California proposed a bill that would ban gas vehicles by 2035. This would be disastrous for many reasons. First up, jobs. This ban would leave hundreds, maybe even thousands of mechanics, journeymen, and other various tradies jobless, unable to pay their bills. With rolling blackouts sweeping across California, it is more than obvious, even to the untrained eye, that their power grid cannot support massive amounts of electric vehicles.
Fungos amo cum sepis et anis leguminibus verus sum bonis sibi amans et haec vox diamonion ens.
Hydrogen combustion engines, HCE, are the future. Instead of the ever more expensive and elusive gasoline, HCEs, as you might have guessed, use compressed hydrogen to burn, with its only byproduct being water. As we all know, car enthusiasts love loud things that go fast. Fortunately, hydrogen engines have the same roar. Personally, I think they sound like a lawnmower taking steroids, but to each their own. With record high inflation and a recession around the corner, many families are stuck taking out massive mortgages on their home to afford groceries, gas, and insurance. Most just don't have the money to buy a $60,000 car with the build quality of a toy.